Welcome to Gears, Part 3. When I first showed this animation to my friend, he said, "Great, but which one's driving the other?" So let's try and fix that. The one on top drives the one on the bottom. Although, this comes with a bit of a drawback that now there is backlash. Today we'll look at some details of this axial shift and learn about the contact ratio. The reason to use increased axial distance is to have clearance between gears. If you design them right on edge, due to manufacturing errors, they might get too close and interfere. So it's better to be on the safe side and be a bit farther away. Of course, you can go too far with it, then the gears just won't work anymore. Moving back to the default position, here are the base circles and the line of action, and the standard pressure angle alpha at 20 degrees. As you apply axial shift, the actual pressure angle changes, it is now more than 20 degrees. So, bad news, you need to keep in mind when to use the standard pressure angle and when to use the actual one. I'll try to keep it clear for the rest of this video. In the default position, these gears have two contact points, well, at least most of the time. When you apply axial shift, the ratio of two-point contact is much lower. If you pull them further apart, at certain angles the gears lose contact. Drawing the addendum circles reveals how little overlap you have. Going back to the viable area, you can see the contact points lie within this kind of eye-shaped region between the addendum circles. It's time to introduce some new terms here. So, the line of action is the line between base circles, this is the generator line of the involute curves. The line of contact is the part of the line of action but limited to the region where actual contact can happen. The distance between the contact points along the line of action is the base pitch. The contact ratio is the ratio between the line of contact and the base pitch. For a pair of gears to work, it is necessary that the contact ratio is larger than 1. This is heavily influenced by the axial distance, so going back to the standard distance, the ratio increases a lot. In the previous video, I talked at length about the undercut. Now you'll be able to see its effect on the contact ratio. So let's switch the top gear to a smaller one. This gear has a lot of undercut, and this limits the contact ratio. In this intermediate position, the gear wouldn't slip like when they're too far apart, but the power would be transferred via the sharp endpoint of the undercut curve, which would break off or wear down quickly. And since it deviates from the involute geometry, the transmission would no longer be smooth. So you need to avoid the undercut by applying profile shift. With the profile shifted gear, we barely got it back to a viable contact ratio, just a little over 1. So why would you want small gears like that anyway? Take a look at these, both realizing 10 to 1 reduction. Which one would you trust to be stronger? Now, I can't let you go without doing some math, so here's how to calculate the line of contact. Start with two gears and triangles drawn using the base circles, addendum circles, and the line of action. You can calculate the length of the line of action L0 using the Pythagorean theorem on the axial distance dA and the sum of the base radii. Next, you can calculate this L1 length, also using Pythagoras as shown. You can do the same thing on the smaller gear for L2. Lastly, you can exploit the overlap between L0, L1 and L2 to find the length of the line of contact. You need to add L1 and L2 and subtract L0. For the base pitch, here's a short explanation. You start with the pitch, which is module times pi. You shift it down along the involutes to the base circle. This will be a similar arc, albeit on a smaller radius. So the length of the arc is proportional to the ratio of the radii, in this case the base radius to pitch radius. This is where you get the base pitch, it's the arc length between base points. If you straighten this line, you can move it along the involute curves. You can see this is a constant perpendicular distance between two curves. This is why you can use the base pitch in the contact ratio calculation. Putting it all together, here's the formula for the contact ratio with some reminders to see what's what. So recall that the addendum radius is just one module larger than the pitch radius, so z plus 2 over 2 times module, plus profile shift if you have any. The base circle radius is pitch radius times cosine of the standard pressure angle. The axial distance dA is at least the sum of the pitch radii, but can be larger. I added this delta value to account for larger than default axial distances, and making it proportional to the module just keeps everything neat. And on the bottom, here's the contact ratio equation in its full glory. Remember that this is only valid for cases without undercutting. Let's take an example here. Here's how the contact ratio changes with axial distance. Delta is the additional distance as a coefficient of the module, and on the y-axis you can see the contact ratio. With this particular setup you can go up to about 0.7 module before you lose contact. And as for undercutting and profile shifting, here's how the contact ratio changes with the number of teeth. In this scenario, different gears are meshed with a 41 tooth gear, with and without profile shift, at nominal axial distance. Since the formula from earlier does not apply to undercut gears, I used a numeric approximation to get the contact ratios, and also the amount of profile shift is optimized for the highest contact ratio. So, without profile shift, 10 is the lowest you can go, while with profile shift, at least in theory, you can go as low as 6 teeth. And that's all I had for you about gears. Honestly speaking, this is already a little more than I'm comfortable to share. I did my research for this video, but I'm not a mechanical designer. I can't back up my claims with real-world experience. Or maybe it's a bit of an imposter syndrome kicking in, who knows. Anyway, stay tuned for new topics and thanks for watching, bye!